blockchain brings hope in the sense that we can return the power to the people. Getting the power back from systems that have grown too old or corrupt, and build better systems that are transparent and that align the interests of people, institutions, and everyone in a better way.
Our existing system just isn't geared up to cope. Some of it dates back hundreds of years. So we need to shift. And what we need to shift to is a system that, as we say, hands more power to the people. In order to do that, we need to move to a system that's obviously secure, that's transparent, where it's uncensorable, you can't change the information once it's there, and where you have much greater say for the participants in the system, and that we find ways of tackling the global wealth gap.
I fully agree with you, Rohit. We have all this situation in which tech is evolving, preserving the interests of monopolies or big companies at the cost of the environment or people and so on and so forth. The problem is that we have exponential power, not accompanied by exponential growth in wisdom, compassion, and consideration for each other, which is a little bit threatening.
Till today, the biggest companies on the planet are all technology companies that have massive, massive power. And something like 10% of the global economy sits in the hands of just six companies. And so we needed something different. So monopolies is a fantastic area to think about in relation to blockchain and crypto. Right now, we're very excited within the community that we may be able to fulfill the promise that the early internet had, that we could break the monopoly power of big tech companies.
There is a fallacy of trying to imagine that, oh, once we have blockchain, we can reboot Uber, we can reboot Airbnb, we can reboot Google, we can redo everything in a decentralized way. I don't think that's the point here. I think it's the birth of a whole new way of doing things, whole new business models.
I don't think we know yet. I think we have our aspiration and our desire, but I don't think we know yet how this will play out over time if we look on a 5, 10, 20 year basis. And maybe we'll be talking about something very different. And so our challenge now is, how does this work? How do we move forward?
What's happening with blockchain and crypto is similar to what happened to the birth of, let's say, mobile, right? Mobile is an interesting technology that it allows for new business models that were not possible before. In the same way, blockchain tech allows for new business models, new engagements between people and institutions that could not be imagined before. I would expect that the way they will grow their network is going to be also a new experiment. And how the current monopolies will be involved in this, I don't really know. One of the risks that I see with hyper-tokenization, we don't want democracy to be reduced to economy, right? That would be a catastrophe. We want people to express their rights and their opinions. We want to preserve the good things that we have in our democratic systems and just go forward, not backward.
But I think I can see more positive examples of what you can do with this than the negative. I'll give you a simple example. What if we tokenized prisons? And we had the community owning some, and we had the official justice system owning some. The governance rules would be very different. The monitoring of conditions in the prisons would be very different. The same could be done with police forces, where if you had that balanced governance through a tokenized architecture, where it's not a monetary thing, it's more a governance thing that you have the tokens. We would change that so you wouldn't have this issue of bias, of prejudice, of unbalanced representation within the police force. So I can see you don't have to monetize everything, but by tokenizing the governance of a lot of these things, we change the model.
But what concerns me about, you know, for instance, the selling votes or tokenizing votes is that somehow you can get this misalignment between the economic interests and the interest over the system that you are voting for. Let's say some party that has extraordinary economic power can buy voting rights of several individuals just to opt for the worst possible option on the table to destroy the system or to ruin whatever you have there.
I think the idea of selling voting rights is disgusting personally, but I also see that across the planet, there are millions and hundreds of millions of people, if not billions of people, who are already suffering and disenfranchised under democracies. So one of the interesting questions here is whether we can bring blockchain thinking, decentralized thinking, and where there's no leadership, no management, there's a community that effectively governs decision making. There's a question about whether we can bring that to different levels of governance, to from a local town all the way through to a nation or a global base. The question is whether we can get all the parties to buy in. Then we could start to bring some very different solutions to the way we tackle climate change, how we run the next COP meeting, and how we get more collaboration on tackling these global challenges.
That's a very good point, Rohit. And I'm very excited to see how that will impact democracy, collective decision making, because you know what? You had to trust a government. Now with blockchain, we changed totally the game or the landscape of possibilities. What we see now are some initiatives like the City DAO and crypto cities. And you see some openness from some governments to explore these new ideas, like the government of Miami. Miami has launched its own crypto coin, which is actually creating revenue, right? And you have Wyoming, which is also recognizing DAOs as legally, right? So you can actually have DAOs that are legally recognized by Wyoming. And these experiments will start to come. Well, first of all, an operating system is a very important invention because it's a kind of a multi-sided platform that allows hardware manufacturers, developers, and users of applications developed by these developers to have a single point where they meet. So once I have an operating system like Linux or like Android, hardware manufacturers make hardware to support that operating system. Then developers don't need to know the intricacies of the hardware. They can develop on top of that thing. They have a lingua franca to develop. What we're trying to do with Cartesi is to bring back a proper OS to Web3, to blockchain, and with that really help to unlock these network effects that we are waiting to see. Right? So it's very important for us to have an OS back here.
I think from a societal point of view, the excitement about blockchain is that will allow us to do, or is allowing us to do, things that we just can't do any other way, or we can't do at the scale we need to. We could not do the kind of decentralized access to savings, to purchasing the assets, without a fully automated set of systems that we see today that allow almost anyone to get in there. We just couldn't do it through the central systems with all their overheads and all of the structures and management hierarchy. We need something ultra low cost, ultra efficient, ultra transparent.
That's beautifully said, Rohit. So in a sense, I was talking about operating system in a literally, you're talking about operating system in a more broad way. And of course, blockchains are a new operating system to create these complex global multi-sided markets, right? And that's quite revolutionary. I think that blockchain is basically an operating system to create this kind of a huge bazaar that, you know, all these people can come together and they have a common ground of trust that they can all benefit and enter a positive feedback loop. Thank you very much. I really appreciated this conversation. It was a real pleasure seeing you here in this interesting futuristic setup, right, and exchange some ideas.
Thank you, Erick. It's been fascinating. I've really enjoyed the experience and the opportunity to hear your views.